This is a, I don't know if you can see my reflection, but I'm using a spy pen as my camera. Notice here, foil tape. I took the trim off. It's a rusted out hole right there. If you go to the bottom, underneath, it's not that bad underneath. Here at the top of the roof, this plastic strip is glued down with silicon because there's a big hole right through there that's leaking. You notice that the silicon for this metal, sheet metal I put here, I attached everything with pop rivets. It replaces the sunroof. There's another big hole right here that I have filled in with silicon also, right there. This is the surface rust. Well, let me open the door. The roof pillars look unaffected, so I don't think there's any structural thing going on. I think it's just the panels that are crazy. Let me show you the underside of the roof. That's where the leak is. I got it filled in with silicone. Put this sunroof pan back on so that I could maybe put in a door skin to finish off the roof. I mean the headliner. So there's a section here of the little shelf that the windshield mounts on, right here, it's missing. It's just not there. And it's filled in with silicon and windshield mastic. There's some rust going on here, elsewhere, but it's not that bad. Also, if you notice, the two bolts back here, those two bolts hold the hinge for the deck lid, but if you go over this way, it's rusted, it's real bad. In fact, one of the bolts is almost completely gone, and that one is still attached. So, I have it treated with rust treatment. It's not, you see that it's black, it's not rust color no more. But that's basically so the leaks are in there and in the front corner here, and then the front edge of where the windshield is. I have these 1x2s here so that I could maybe attach the door skin to them, okay, and finish it off. If you notice the back seat here, it's got all this these rust particles that have fallen down. This is what falls on your head when you drive. I can't stand this. This is insane, okay? That third brake light thing, I had to make that out of metal myself because the plastic one broke. That electrical wire hanging there, that's the connector for the third brake light. So you have to put a new third brake light in there to because the old one, it's no good. It broke. The rear glass is tinted. The quarter panels are tinted. The side windows are tinted. This vinyl here is torn, and on the other side also. If you see down here, this is where it's always been leaking. It's rusted out along here. This seat rail is attached okay here, but it's loose. It's not even attached on this other end. It's just loose. The other ones are in pretty good shape. I'm going to connect the battery and start the car and prove to you that the engine works. Let's get this thing going. You see that I have 138,000 miles on this car. So here's how you start it. You push in the clutch pedal. You take it out of gear. Make sure it's in neutral. And then you put the key in and you turn it so the dash lights come on. And then you go over here to the sunroof button and you push it upwards. And it starts. So, the engine works. I'm going to get out and show you the engine. There it is. In all of its glory. So there's proof that it works.